Hi there, welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. More than 170,000 people have been impacted by the catastrophic wildfires in Los Angeles. But what surprises me the most is that in spite of all the technological advancements in AI, it was not used to predict the wildfire. So in this video, I'm going to show you on how to use AI and deep learning to predict wildfire events. I'll be starting by showing you the approach, and then we'll go into a visual demo. And then I'll show you some Python code and tools. Now, one of the tools which I've used is my own AI assistant called as datajarvis.ai, and you can also try it out. So let's jump into the topic. But before that, do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video. Wildfires are caused when two things come together. An event such as climate change or lightning or even fire caused due to electrical wires. And the second is when this event occurs in a geographical area which has got risk of fire. So in this video, I'll focus on how to use AI to classify if a geographical area is at risk of fire or not. The approach is to collect satellite data from areas where the wildfire has occurred, as well as from areas where the wildfire has not occurred. And then train a deep learning model which will be able to learn which features differentiate between these two type of areas. And then we can use this deep learning model to predict wildfire risk for any new area. In this demo, I'll be taking satellite images from Quebec in Canada. Now, here are some satellite images of areas where the wildfire has actually occurred. And in some of these images, you can also see a fire scare, which is shown in dark color. And you'll also see that most of the images seems to be related to forest areas. And here are some of the satellite images of areas where the wildfire has not occurred. And you can see that most of the images have some kind of building or construction in it. Now, here is a geospatial heat map for all the satellite images which are related to wildfire. And you can observe that the south of Quebec has got high risk of wildfire. Now, we can train a deep learning model based on CNN, also called as the convolutional neural network. And this model takes images related to wildfire as well as images related to not a wildfire. A CNN model basically tries to learn important characteristics which differentiate between a wildfire and not a wildfire directly from the images. You can think of this as identifying a specific shape in the image. So, for example, if an image has got more forest areas or more vegetation compared to constructions and building, it will learn that this is an important criteria which can create a risk of wildfire. Now, once the model is trained, we can use it to make predictions on any new satellite image. So let's see a demo. So let me first go ahead and select an image. Now the image has been now selected, and let us now predict using the deep learning model. I'll also show you the Python code behind this in a while. All right, the prediction indicates that there is no risk of wildfire, and you can see that this area has got some buildings and construction as well as got some vegetation. You'll also see a green line, which indicates the presence of some darker areas. And these darker areas indicate the presence of vegetation. But because these areas of vegetation are less compared to buildings, it has predicted that this image has got less risk of wildfire. Now let us take another image and let me hit the prediction button. All right, so the prediction indicates that there is a risk of wildfire, and you can see that this image has got areas which are mostly vegetation. And you can also see the green area, which is much larger, which also indicates that the presence of high vegetation compared to buildings and construction. So there is a risk of wildfire. Let us now jump into some Python code and tools. I'll be using Jupyter Notebook for Python, and I'll be using my own tool called as Data Jarvis for geospatial visualization. And let me start with the Jupyter Notebook. We need multiple libraries such as PyTorch for deep learning, Torch Vision and GradCam for explainable AI, as well as widgets for UI. The training data is stored in two directories, the wildfire and no wildfire. And the name of the satellite images also has got latitude and longitude. So it will be interesting to extract this data and use it for data exploration. So here is the code which goes through all the files to extract the latitude and longitude information, and it saves it in a CSV file. Now let us take this CSV file and produce some stunning geospatial visualization using my own platform, datajarvis.ai. First, I will upload the CSV file and then save it as a data source. All right, so the data has been now saved, and let us now go to the chat. Let me select the data set which we have loaded, and we can also make a data preview. And let us now give a prompt such as give a geospatial heat map with longitude and latitude. And let me hit enter. And in a while, I will get this cool looking geospatial visualization. This looks pretty awesome. Now, let me jump back to the Jupyter notebook. Now, here is the code to train the model. And here I've selected GPU device MPS as I am on my MacBook. And I've also indicated the directory, which has got two folders, the Wildfire and not the Wildfire. I need to first resize all the images so that all the images has got similar dimensions, 128 by 128. And the images are also normalized to 0.5 mean and standard deviation. The data loader will read all the data, and it is important to note that the labels will be automatically assigned based on the structure of the directory. So the Wildfire is assigned a label as 0, and no Wildfire is assigned a label as 1. I'll also use the CNN model, which has got two convolutional neural layers followed by two fully connected layers. You can now train the model using this code. And as you can see that the loss decreases for each run. For the purpose of demo, I've just fixed it to 10 runs, but you can also continue with more runs to improve your model accuracy. And once the model is trained, you can save the model. We can then use this model to predict the risk of wildfire based on any new image. Now, for understanding the prediction, I'm using a very good library called as GradCam. And you can also envelop the prediction as well as the explanation using an UI called as widgets. You'll also get a nice UI where you can upload any new image and get the prediction as well as an explanation of the prediction, indicating why the image has got risk of wildfire or not a risk of wildfire. So my friends, hopefully you have enjoyed this video. Please do not forget to subscribe to the channel, comment and like on the video, and see you soon in another exciting demo video.